Hi everybody, this is Paul Kopf and today it's time to experiment with the brand new RoomPack7, Großes Festspielhaus Salzburg, and the second venue that comes with it. For those of you who want to do the same, get your free demo licenses on the product pages. The links are in the video description below. So let's start. Karl Böhm Hall is a large foyer adjacent to several significant venues of the Salzburg Festival, such as Felsenreitschule, Haus für Mozart and Großes Festspielhaus. It's a great sounding room with a large and very lively ambience, ideal for those fanfares with broad reverbs. But today we're doing something completely different. We'd like to present this room as the world's largest reverb chamber in 3D, offering a host of reverberation options. In this video, we're using drums to explore the sonic colors of this marvelous room, and in the process, we demonstrate how you can use Vienna MIR Pro 3D as a reverb chamber, where placement, one of MIR's unique features, is not used in the conventional way to place instruments of the orchestra authentically on stage, but to create different reverb sounds and characteristics. We'll hear how changes such as position, direction of the sound source, as well as of the microphone, will affect the sound of the reverb. We're using a 16-bar loop from our Synchron Power Drums. You'll hear the sonar drum set playing with only the closed mics on and all the room mics turned off. And this is how it sounds dry. Now we're placing the drums in the middle of this hall. Of course, the reverb sounds amazing, but this is way too much for what we usually want for drums in a mix. So as a first step, we're reducing the reverb length to 1 second. And suddenly, this is an amazing room for drum mixing. For comparison, here's the dry signal. And back to the room. The drums are playing right in front of the microphone. We're using a cardioid profile for the sound source, which is the submix of the drums in our case. So there is more sound emanating to the front and less to the back. Let's hear how the room sound changes when we turn the sound source around. We're hearing more reflections from the stone wall in the back of the hall. And let's turn it back to the microphone again. Now let's talk about wet and dry for a moment and the volume of the dry signal. For this demonstration, we're using the pop mode of MIR, which means wherever you place your sound source in the room, even far away from the main microphone, the dry signal keeps the same volume, and you can easily adjust the room level using the wet-dry handle. This would be different, for example, in the classical and scoring modes, where we have the option that the direct signal gets more reduced the further back we're placing an instrument. So in this setting, and for the purpose of this video, we can control wet and dry directly using the MIR icon. Of course, when you're using MIR as an aux send reverb, you'd have MIR set to 100% wet by clicking on wet solo and add the reverb to your dry signal using your DAW's mixer. So let's start experimenting and move the drums a bit to the back of the room. We're hearing a different reverb sound. It changes again when we move the drums even further back. To change the room sound even more, we're increasing the stereo width of the sound source. Now let's turn the drums to the back, and we're clearly hearing the reflections from the stone wall on this side of the room. Again, to the front. And to the back. And as a reminder, here's our original dry signal. So we keep this orientation and we move back to the middle position. Now we're suddenly hearing a great sounding slapback echo. Let's move close to the microphone. That's a totally different characteristic because now we are far away from the back wall. Let's turn around to face the microphone again. And now let's see what happens when we place the drums on the balcony. We can clearly hear the distance. Let's mix things up and use the other microphone that's in a height of 4 meters or about 13 feet. Of course, we're getting more direct signal from the drums playing up there. Now let's keep the microphone and move the drums back to the floor, so they're playing below the mic. And yet again, we're getting a new room sound. The wide signal sounds a bit strange, so let's make it narrower. And of course, we can now point the microphone down towards the drums. Compare, let's point the mic towards the ceiling, away from the source. Okay, let's point towards the drums again. In the same vein, we can point the source towards the elevated microphone. We can even do this automatically by activating the auto-aim function. Finally, on the other side, there's the wooden end of the room. There are two microphones back there as well, in a height of 2 meters and 4 meters respectively. And of course, this side offers all kinds of colors too. And we're moving up to the balcony on this side of the room. As a reminder, this is what we started with. And this is the full length of the reverb, 2.6 seconds. So there you have it. This great sounding room functions as an amazing 3D reverb chamber in stereo and of course also in surround and immersive formats, adding dimension and character to any signal. Explore the new possibilities for your music production with free demo licenses for MIR Pro 3D and all 7 room packs. Feed MIR Pro 3D with your own recordings, be it acoustic recordings or virtual instruments, and find out which venue fits your music in a matter of seconds. Subscribe to this channel and stay tuned for more tutorials, product announcements, interviews, and great music. Have a beautiful day.